trouble is a caprice in childhood, a passion in youth, a necessity in manhood, and an elegy in old age.
During our hero's time, including Dr. Rizal, traveling in different places is very limited to every Filipino, since money is not that easy to gain in Spanish time, and that makes the fare expensive.
At that time, there were no airships like helicopters or airplanes that would hastily bring people to a certain place as we have today. The major transportation means were horsepower and trains.
Dr. Jose Rizal was traveling to different places to widen his knowledge in terms of different kinds of beliefs and culture he visits.
In this vlog, we'll talk about the different levels and travels of Dr. Jose Rizal, the values, beliefs, and knowledge he learned, the friends he met during those travels, the places he visits, and many more. This will also deal with the interest of Dr. Jose Rizal.
Right now, we'll talk about Dr. Jose Rizal's broad knowledge and develop skills that will later on have the reasons of downfall to the 333 years of Spanish reign.
Rizal first trip abroad. On May 3, 1882, Rizal left Philippines for the first time Spain. He boarded the Salvadora using a passport of Jose Mercado, which was procured for him by his uncle Antonio Rivera, father of Leonor Rivera. He was accompanied to the quay where the Salvadora was moored by his uncle Antonio Vicente Gela and Mateo Evangelista. June 15, 1882, he left Marseilles for Barcelona in express train. Rizal in Barcelona, Spain, August 1882, has articled Amor Patrio, was published in Dayarong Tagalog, a Manila newspaper, edited by Basilio Teodoro. This was the first article he wrote abroad.
Rizal in Madrid, Spain, September 2, 1882, Rizal matriculated at the Universidad Central de Madrid. He taught the following subjects: medical clinic, surgical clinic, legal medicine, and obstetrical clinic.
Rizal back in Madrid. 2008, September 1883, he enrolled at the Central Universidad de Madrid for the second course in medicine.
Rizal in Heidelberg, Germany. On April 22, 1886, while in Heidelberg, experienced the feelings of nostalgia for his parents and for his country. Then, Rizal wrote a poem. It's called A Last Flourish to Heidelberg.
Rizal in Manila. August 5, 1887, at 9 o'clock in the evening, Rizal arrived at Manila after 5 years of study and patriotic labors in Europe.
In December 29, 1887, permanent board of censure headed by Father Salvador Font issued a judgment absolutely prohibiting the circulation of the Salimitanary in the Philippines.
Rizal back in Madrid. On the 23rd of August 1890, he reported to Juan Luna what transpired between him and Antonio Luna. Antonio Luna and Rizal had a quarrel, and they also had a duel.
May 1, 1891, in a letter sent to Baza, Rizal reiterated again his desire to be an uncle, reminding the former of the amount he was borrowing for his family.
Rizal in Ghent, Belgium. July 9, 1891, Rizal was financially hard. He did not receive for 3 months up to this day any pension from him. He was living in the most difficult situation, renting his small room and eating the modest food in order to economize and be able to publish the editorial piece.
After having been inspected by custom men, he boarded in the Oriente Hotel where he occupied room number 22, facing the Binondo Church. His sister Lucia accompanied him in his return to the Philippines.
July 3, 1892, Dr. Jose Rizal had an interview again with Governor General Bispohol. He thanked Governor General for lifting the order of exile for his sister. Governor General told him to come back the following Wednesday.
He was ordered in prison in Fort Santiago from July 6 to 15, exiled to the Pitan.
July 15, 1892, at 1 o'clock in the morning, Rizal was shipped on board the boat S.S. Cebu to Dapitan. He was given good cabin but well guarded.
Rizal in Dapitan, he engaged in agriculture, fishing, and business. He maintained and operated a hospital. He conducted classes and taught the pupils English and Spanish languages and arts.
Dr. Jose Rizal is said to be the most troubled Filipino hero in the history. The travel and adventure of Jose Rizal are important surface of his education and mission for the Philippines because of his broad knowledge of different culture that he learned from his journey, and it became his inspiration for reform. Upon his travel, Jose Rizal experienced struggle that led reform to the Philippines.